Ever wondered why it's so difficult to get real-world assets like US Treasury bills into the crypto space? Like, why can't you just buy them on the blockchain? Well, here's where Ondo Finance comes into play. Ondo Finance wants to bring financial tools to everyone using the power of blockchain, and in this video, we are going to explain how. By the end of it, you will know what Ondo Finance is, how Ondo works with Coinbase and BlackRock to bring you tokenized US Treasury bills, and what the tokenomics of the Ondo, OUSG and USDY tokens are. So let's get started. Alright, so what is Ondo Finance? Ondo Finance was created in 2021 by Nathan and Pinku with backgrounds from places like Goldman Sachs. They saw the need to make financial products better and easier to get to using blockchain technology. Ondo's main goal is to tokenize real-world assets like US Treasury bills and put them on the blockchain. This allows more people to use these assets in the decentralized finance world. One example of what Ondo's done is create things like OUSG, which gives investors a token version of US Treasuries. This links traditional finance with decentralized finance by providing a clear and regulated way to invest in real-world assets on-chain. Let's say you want to buy a tiny piece of a US Treasury bill without going through the usual banking steps. Ondo Finance lets you buy a token instead. The token represents that bill piece, making it easier to access and using crypto. But how does Ondo Finance work to bring US Treasuries to the DeFi world? It involves a few key players, and understanding how they all fit together is very important. It all starts with a structure designed to ensure safety and compliance. Think of Ondo as building a safe, secure bridge for your money to travel from the crypto world to US Treasuries. To do this, they've created a fund. So, what exactly is this fund? Think of it as a special legal container called Ondo ILP, created specifically to hold the US Treasury bills that back the OUSG token I mentioned earlier. When you invest in OUSG, you start by depositing USDC, which is then converted into USD. Why? Because the US Treasury market operates in traditional US dollars, not in stable coins like USDC. Coinbase is responsible for this conversion. After this conversion, the USD becomes part of the fund, which is officially named Ondo ILP. This fund is designed to hold and manage the underlying assets that back OUSG tokens. More than 99.5% of the fund's assets are then invested into the BlackRock USD Institutional Digital Liquidity Fund, also called BIDL. BIDL is managed by BlackRock, one of the world's most experienced and trusted asset managers. Essentially, the USD in the fund is used to buy shares of BIDL, where BlackRock carefully manages the portfolio to generate returns. Now, what does BIDL hold? BIDL primarily invests in US Treasury bills, along with other highly liquid, low-risk assets like bank deposits and money market funds. These assets provide stability and a steady, predictable yield. Importantly, BIDL's assets are custodied by BNY Mellon, one of the largest and most secure banks in the world, overseeing nearly $50 trillion in client assets. This traditional layer of protection ensures that these investments are safely managed and safeguarded against risk. The foundation of this entire structure is the US Treasuries themselves. These are debt securities issued by the US government and backed by its full faith and credit, making them some of the safest and most reliable investments in the world. In short, when you invest in OUSG, you are not just buying a token, you are accessing a carefully constructed system built on trusted institutions like Coinbase, BlackRock and BNY Mellon, with the US government itself backing the ultimate investments. Ondo Finance has created a bridge between the decentralized finance world and this stable, ultra-secure asset class, making it easier for anyone to access what are traditionally institutional-grade investments. Alright, let's now explore the tokenomics of Ondo Finance. Ondo Finance has three main tokens: Ondo, OUSG and USDY, each serving a different purpose within the Ondo ecosystem. The Ondo token has a maximum supply of 10 billion tokens and it's the native governance and utility token of the ecosystem. It allows holders to participate in decision-making processes such as voting on protocol upgrades and governance proposals. Additionally, Ondo is used as a reward for liquidity providers and ecosystem participants. The initial token allocation was as follows: 52.1% was allocated to the ecosystem growth, 33% to protocol development, 12.9% to private sales, and the last 2% to community access sale. Unlike Ondo, OUSG and USDY don't have a fixed supply. Their issuance grows with demand, increasing as more investors buy these tokens. As I mentioned earlier, OUSG is a tokenized version of short-term US treasuries, giving investors access to a safe asset. It earns yield over time, making it a low-risk option for accredited investors looking to preserve their wealth on the blockchain. USDY, on the other hand, is a tokenized secured note for non-US investors, backed by US treasuries and demand deposits. It offers a strong US dollar yield and comes in two forms, one that grows in value over time and another called MUSD that distributes yield daily with extra tokens. So, summing it up, Ondo Finance basically wants to bridge the gap between traditional and decentralized finance by tokenizing real-world assets like US Treasury bills. It offers access to these assets using trusted partners and following rules. As always, nothing is ever guaranteed in crypto, of course. Changes in regulations and the market, as well as management from the top, could affect Ondo's future. Ondo Finance could change how we access and use real-world assets in DeFi. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to learn more about Ondo, I leave a link to my article in the description below. See you in the next video. Bye!